Today, we're diving into the best productivity applications for extending your productivity. And what do I mean by that? Essentially, what I'm trying to talk about is apps that aren't necessarily task, calendar, or notes, but are useful in different ways, in whether that's helping to fine-tune your focus, helping to remove distractions, or quality improvements and quality of life improvements in other areas. So these are all going to be apps that are side apps, almost assisting apps to the productivity system you may have. Now, if you're interested in finding all of these in a bit more detail, go over to Toolfinder linked below and you'll find everything. An in-depth guide into all of these and a little bit more about how they can be helpful for you. And if you're new here, subscribe. So let's dive into the list. Number one is Raycast. Now, if you haven't heard of Raycast, it's basically a way on Mac to essentially use a keyboard shortcut to bring up a menu for yourself. But what's interesting is it has apps within it. So imagine your spotlight function on Mac, where you bring up and search for different apps as part of your whole Mac and whole experience. It's got apps inside of that. So you can even open things like your schedule for the day without having to go inside your Google Calendar, which is really interesting. And it's got loads of integrations with apps like Notion too. And Raycast has been really popular for a lot of people, and we do have a review coming soon. Number two is Zoom Mail. This was fairly recently we launched. It's still currently in beta, but Zoom Mail is a way for you to see all of your emails in different type of experience. Say you take a lot of Zoom calls every day and you want to upgrade to their more popular work enterprise plans. Zoom Mail is now part of that, giving you a way to plug in your email and start working on them without leaving the experience. So this is great for somebody who spends a lot of time in Zoom, booking meetings, planning meetings, and wanting their email in there too. Number three is Apple Freeform. We've got a video about that. Essentially, Apple Freeform is a whiteboard-like experience that you can collaborate with others on. So in real time, you can do a video call to somebody and also annotate and collaborate using your Apple Pencil on your iPad. An interesting experience that does have an iPhone application, but pretty unworthy compared to the iPad version for sure. This is great for expressing ideas and bringing together with collaboration in real time with other people. Number four, if you find that in Todoist you lack the focus ability, obviously there's task view where you can go and see a focused view of your tasks. If you want a more focused view, there's an app called Floist, which you can plug in, which helps you to enhance the focus view there and really drill down on one task. Sometimes the Todoist task view can be stressful because you can see other tasks, subtasks in that, but this really blocks all of that out and enhances what you have with Todoist. Number five is Sessions. If you're somebody that wants a timer and wants a little bit of analytics behind it, Sessions is probably the most gorgeous timer application on the market and is beautiful. And it has analytics, so if you pay for their premium plan, you can write notes and get analytics on how you felt during the day to give you establishing moments of how much time you focused, and using systems like the Pomodoro to really zoom into that and have high quality breaks, high quality sessions that you're doing. So really interesting app for sure. Number six is a habit tracking app. We've got a couple of these in this list. Habitify is a well-known one on the market that is so good with helping you to collect all of your habits. Interesting feature is they've got a great way to analyze all of the streaks and processes that you've done before. So if you want to see how well you're progressing, how many days of the year you have percentage success on, this is a great app for that. And it's really well renowned on the iOS App Store, and also they have additional apps too. Number seven is much more of a web-based app. They do have mobile apps, but to be honest, the web version is really nice. So it's great. Another habit tracking app, sorry, but Every Day is a beautiful experience for tracking habits, and most importantly, for the way it visually represents it. It comes up in this lovely green view, and you can change the color, I know that, but it's great for being able to see visually, okay, this is how much progress I've made on habits this year, and I don't want to break the streak because it's so visual. A lot of people do like that, and it does have some scientific backing, I believe, in that element of helping to keep focused on completing a habit for the year. So number eight is like a CRM tool, and you're probably going, Francesco, don't recommend me CRM tools. I hear enough about them at work. This is slightly different. Think of LinkedIn, but think of a service that is a lot more lighter in its experience. Don't think about posts, think about the way that you interact with people, managing relationships. Play is a free application. It does have a premium experience that offers you a way to plug in things like LinkedIn, messages, Twitter, etc. and essentially keep those relationships bubbling, telling you where you should reoccurrence in terms of who you should recontact, who you should write notes on when you interact with them, making sure you don't forget things like birthdays, etc. And it's really nice because it keeps you reminded of what's important and to make you sure you reach out to those people that you haven't contacted in a while. Keep those relationships bubbling and also see updates on all what people were working on. But what's interesting, not very like LinkedIn, mess. It's just updates on how people have updated their LinkedIn bio or Twitter bio, subtle ones that people wouldn't see necessarily from LinkedIn because it's different to posting, if that makes sense. Number 9 is Opal. It's one that I've played around with a little bit, but Opal blocks apps helping you to focus on your work. But it's different because it's a very much an iOS application that centers around, I believe there's an Android app too, I believe it centers around basically using previously used a VPN to essentially block you from going into certain apps and blocking time out for that, which is really nice. So it's sort of like a virtual assistant on your iPhone that helps you to keep focus when you're distracting and really keep track of that as well if you were to. Setting limitations, which is really nice. For some people, this is a great way to really stop and fine tune the processes. Obviously, if you're looking for a more freemium option, there is Apple Screen Time, which you can do if you're on iOS devices. And I believe Google have similar services on their more recent Android versions too. So number 10 is Typefully. To be honest, I tweet a lot, but I don't like to tweet in real time as much because I tend to like to schedule my tweets because I like to normally have ideas and be able to spout them, but not necessarily straight away. So Typefully helps me to schedule them and plan them in advance. I really like it for that ability. Well worth checking out. It does come with a premium experience, but to be honest, it's one of the ones that I love paying for to help me enhance my Twitter use. Next up is Miro, number 11. Miro presents a really interesting experience for managing and collaborating with other people, but I like it for idea capture and bringing together visual representations of things, whether that's flowcharts or ideas that you're having. We've used it in loads of videos and it's well worth checking out if you're interested in just visually expressing things that doesn't limit you things like Canva, etc., and allows you to collaborate with other people, sharing that board really easily. Number 12 is Setapp. And Setapp is one of these things that I typically recommend for freelancers or those who are starting a business and don't want to pay huge upfront app costs. This is a good buy if you're looking for a ton of apps, even productivity apps, and you don't necessarily want to pay for them and you want to just test them out and sort of experience it. This has got a great set of productivity apps on it. And what's nice about it is it does come at a much more sensible price. I believe it's between $12 and $15 per month. But imagine paying the upfront costs for a lot of these apps will be largely greater. I think Sessions, which we mentioned earlier in this video, is actually on it too. So number 13 is Loom. I'm an avid lover of Loom, and there's a couple of alternatives out there, but Loom is a great one for asynchronous leaving of guides, messages, and things like that. We use it quite heavily at the Keep Productive team because we try not to have meetings whatsoever. So we try and leave little messages for each other, explaining our problems and being able to just set up guides as well and recommendations for doing it asynchronously and using it whilst you're, you know, like not having to explain stuff over and over again, which is a really nice ability. Number 14, if you don't already use a scheduling experience, there's a couple of them, but Calendly is probably one of the biggest one. A great way to advance your booking system and really take more control of who books appointments with you. And you can choose one slot on the free plan, but it does present a great way to save a bit of time instead of constantly emailing people. You can just send them your Calendly link and people will love that. Be able to just jump in and find a slot with you. Number 15 is Arc Browser. There's a few of these sort of productivity browsers out there, but Arc Browser is getting a lot of attention, currently invite only, but presents and built off of the Chrome experience, Chromium browser, I believe it's called, but extended into a really nice package. Arc Browser does a few things different, allowing you to have a note capturing within your browser and does a few things with the blocking of distractions and really nice way to access bookmarks. I'm probably gonna move to it as my go-to experience for managing, you know, using the internet basically. And I find it looks really visually stunning too whilst you're using it. I think that's all of the apps. I said 15 plus, but there's also other apps out there with browsers like Sigma OS, I believe it's called, another alternative solution for browsing. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. Please do make sure to check out Toolfinder for finding having every tool you need ever. You'll find it linked in the description below. A big, big thank you for stopping by. Please do subscribe if you're brand new to Keep Productive, and I look forward to helping you with more app selections in the future. Thanks very much, folks, and cheerio.